When you're building a Power BI report, do you find it difficult to balance where you have a clean, simple, intuitive report page, but also you want to make sure that you're including enough data that gives people what they want? Hi, my name is Anne from Adair-Major Consulting. We help businesses turn data into insights. And today I'm going to show you how drill through in Power BI helps you strike that balance. It allows you to design clear, simple dashboards, but still gives your users the ability to dive into the data. I know that when I build reports for clients, that if we put everything on one page, it becomes really cluttered and hard to use. But if we don't put enough information, people are left asking, where do the numbers come from? Well, this is a really common problem. One way I like to think about it is the example of a retail website. So, for example, on the product page, you have all the different products and really high-level information. Then, as a consumer, if you're interested in one particular item, you know that you can click it and then find all the information there. Well, drill through is the same. You can design your reports so that key numbers stand out, either in visualizations of charts or in cards where it's actually the number. Your users can then choose to right-click and drill through, bringing them to a new page that contains more information about the items that they've just clicked. So we're going to build it together step by step. I've used a data set that's available in Power BI as a sample data set, and here you'll see how I've accessed that. You can load that data straight into your model, and you can follow along at home if you want. So I've already built out a simple landing page, a few cards with key metrics, including total profit, and a line chart and a slicer. So this is the kind of summary view that works well with lots of different stakeholders. It's clear and it's easy to scan and gives that high-level picture. What it doesn't tell you is what's driving the profit, things like segment, product, customer detail, and that's exactly where drill through comes in. I've added a new page, and for this example, I've called it drill through, but you can call it whatever you want, and then hide it so it doesn't distract when it's in the navigation pane. On this page, I'm going to build out some granular visuals. A table is always a good start to really give a lot of detail, and I'll also make it a little bit more visual by adding a pie chart. This particular version is not a very pretty page, and that's fine for this example, but do continue to apply good user experience practices so that even though you're providing a lot more detail, you still don't want to overload the user. Here is the most important step. With no visual selected, I'll open up page information and change the page type to drill through. I'll also switch on keep all filters toggle. This means if I've got slicers and filters on the main page, these carry through in detail. Then I'll drag profit into drill through filters as well. This is where a lot of people get confused, including myself when I first started using drill through. Drill through isn't set up on the visual you want to drill through from. It's on the drill through page that you want to go to. It's the page itself that becomes drill through ready. Then what you do is you apply fields to that page. So no matter what visuals those fields are included on, it gives the report user the ability to drill through to this page. Back on the main report page, if I right-click on profit and choose drill through and then choose my drill through page, instantly, I'm taken to the new detailed view, already filtered. Now, drilling through from the total profit card doesn't look that different, but as you can see, if I choose other options and right-click on the charts, then I'm able to drill through based on the details there. So you'll see the results on the drill through page are dynamic based on what I've drilled through from. That's the power of drill through. To keep the summary page simple, but just with a few clicks, you can jump straight into the detail. Now, once you're here, how do you get back? Every drill through page, as soon as it becomes a drill through page, gets this back button up at the top left. So whenever I drill through, I can hit back and return to the main page that I came from. And it feels really seamless. When you're using Power BI Desktop, to use the buttons, just hold down Control when you click. But once you upload it into the Power BI service, you won't have to hold down Control. Now that we have it working for one field, you can also add as many fields as you want. So whenever those fields appear in any visualization, your end user can drill through to this same page based on any of these fields you've added into this pane. And there you go, you have drill through. This works really well. But there's one problem. A lot of people don't know that they have to right click or that they can right click. So how do we make that more obvious? Here is my absolute pro trick when it comes to drill through. Did you know that you can add a drill through button? On my summary page, I've also added a table here because drill through buttons work best on a category field and not a number like we had before. I insert a blank button and add text like more info. Then in the action settings, I'll set it to drill through. And again, pick my drill through page. So now watch what happens when I click on categories within the table. The button literally lights up. And when I press it, I'm taken straight to that drill through page based on what I had selected before. That's huge for usability. No hidden right clicks. The report tells you exactly where to go. If you found this video helpful, why not check out our video on slicers? I'm going to leave it just here. Slicers and drill through work really well together. They're all about giving your users next level control. Why not check it out? Thank you for watching.